we were sitting with the herd, and after we left them, the lions came through. So at least my ears weren't lying. We were in the right spot. Oh, tired kitty. Happy kitty, full belly. Time for a snooze. So the males just got up and walked to a different piece of shade, a little bit closer. So quite fortunately, we can now have visual of both. Winter season, our dry season, and now that we're in a bit of a drought, or in a big drought at the moment, the lions are killing a lot more buffalo. So I'm not exactly sure which Birmingham boy that is. Chase them. Well, maybe it is Crapper. He's got a very... No, it's not. I don't think so. Then what do you think?
I don't know.
Unfortunately, I haven't spent enough time with the Birminghams to know them that well. But he's got a very fresh scar across his right eye. There we go. Look at that. She's got a mate. Now, that often happens at the beginning of mating. That's amber eyes. Look at that. Wasn't that incredible? And that one female very much looks like amber eyes. He's probably going to move this carcass into the shade now as it gets a bit warmer. I'm very happy my predictions seem to have come true. Taking it off to the shade. For this line in particular, I don't think it's Scrapper. He always looks like, or Tsotsi. He always looks like he's got a black eye. With a nice scar like that. I'm almost tempted to call him Scar. What about you, Wium?
Still fits
there. Does fit. Or Scarface rather than Scar. And there we go, you see he's using his molars and premolars to crunch and cut. Oh, he's got a bit of sinew stuck there. I just imagine lions, if they had the option, would need a lot of toothpicks.